There is another type of stock that some companies issue, which is known as preferred shares of stock, preferred stock shares. So we've just looked at common stock shares or equity, and now let's see how we would calculate the cost of preferred stock. Okay, from chapter 8, in which we had a brief comparison of common stock and preferred stock, we learned that preferred stock is a form of what we call equity. Preferred stockholders must receive a dividend before the investors who buy common stock shares. This is where the name preferred stock comes from. They have preference in receiving dividends over other investors who hold common stock shares. Preferred stockholders, they only receive a so-called stated dividend, which means it's fixed, let's say $2 every year forever. Whereas with common stock dividends, the dividend may be higher in good years when the company has higher profits, and the dividend may be low or nothing at all in bad years for the company. Then to calculate the value of a preferred stock share, we essentially use the same approach as we do for valuing common stock shares. It's this, the present value of all future annual dividends. But because preferred stock dividends are fixed every year, it becomes a perpetuity. So we need to find the present value of a perpetuity of future dividends, because it's the same dividend paid every time period forever. So let's review the formula for that. Because it's the same dividend every year forever, to find the stock price today, denoted by capital P subscript 0, where 0 stands for year 0, we need to find the present value of this perpetuity of dividends, which never end. From chapter 6, in which we looked at the calculation of a perpetuity present value, we need to take the repeating cash flow amount, which is the dividend for our preferred stock, and divide it by the discount rate, capital R subscript P. That's what we denoted in this chapter. And in this chapter, the discount rate is looked at from the perspective of the firm that pays, you know, the dividend every year to the holders of preferred stock shares. And we call it cost of preferred stock. So to rearrange this formula to solve for the cost of preferred stock, or RP, we need to take the dividend amount and divide it by the present value, which is the stock price today. So rearranging gives the cost of preferred stock formula. RP, cost of preferred stock, equals the dividend amount divided by the price per share today. Let's look at this example. A firm has preferred stock with an annual dividend of $3. Current stock price is $25. What is the cost of preferred stock? Solution, using the cost of preferred stock formula, RP, which is the cost of preferred stock notation, equals dividend D divided by price per share today, capital P subscript 0. So we plug in the numbers, the dividend is $3, and we divide it by the price per share of stock today, $25, which gives us 0.12 in decimals, or a 12% cost of preferred stock, which can be interpreted as it costs the company 12% per year to use money raised from preferred stock issues. So when one share is sold and an investor pays $25 for it, then in return for using $25 for the firm's businesses, the firm is going to be required to pay back every year forever $3, which is a 12% 12% of out of $25. So $3 going from the firm to the investor every year forever is 12% kind of cost of using $25.